是24号来自湖南赛区的肖七，
我是48号选手韩丽娜，来自北京。
我叫从乐，来自黑龙江。
我叫张子宁。
那时候不刚好是非典吗？然后要在家里休息啊，然后学习啊。当时就恰好看到报纸上有一个新丝路北京模特大赛的报名宣传，我的朋友就跟我说，哎呀，你身材这么好，要不要去试一试啊？但当时觉得，哎呀，这简直是不可能的事情。当时我还是一个纯粹的大学生，然后也业余的是一名业余的运动员，所以觉得这舞台啊，还有照相机啊，还有漂亮的衣服啊，都是与我无缘的。但是还是抱着试一试的心情，因为当时实在是大家都在放假，没有什么事情做，所以就利用那段时间去瘦身啊，减肥啊，然后学一些化妆的技术啊。
32号选手张子宁来自北京赛区，19岁，身高1米84。
现在依然记得我第一次参加模特大赛的时候，因为之前从来没有接触过高跟鞋，我就晚上就是趁着没人的时候，我也不敢在家里走，因为会吵到楼下的邻居嘛，我就穿着高跟鞋，然后在楼下那个我们小区里面就来回溜达。当时觉得，哎呦，这个好难穿，特别难走。
天涯海角杯2003新丝路中国模特大赛10家选手分别是。
48号韩丽娜，
12号选手伸展，
14号选手武芳，
32号选手张子宁。
In 2003, Zhang Zilin became a part-time model, and while still a second-year student of the University of Science and Technology Beijing, as well as one of the school's track and field athletes, she won the top 10 title in the China's New Silk Road Model Look 2003 final.Afterwards, she signed contracts with New Silk Road Model Limited and left track and field. From that point on, both the way she dressed and her temperament began to change.
现在我的同学见到我，他们都非常感觉难以置信，说哇，子林，你现在怎么那么变得那么女人，有点不适应。我最喜欢的可能是比较偏重于比较优雅或者比较淑女的衣服，就好像我家里有许许多多的连衣裙，然后各种各样不同的颜色，还有很多很多的芭蕾舞鞋。我特别喜欢带蝴蝶结的那种芭蕾舞鞋，大概有20-30双的样子。在我之前练体育的时候，鞋柜里面是运动鞋最多，打开鞋柜所有的全都是运动鞋，但是现在打开鞋柜，可能高跟鞋和芭蕾舞鞋就会占绝大多数。
However, even though Zhang Zilin had been highly visible on the fashion stage in the 4 years from when she started out as a part-time model to becoming a professional model, the lights of the media focused on famous supermodels with high business value. And at the time, Zhang was not confident about her appearance. In 2007, Zhang Zilin took part in the Beijing selection contest for Miss China.Even on the eve of the contest, she wrote in her blog, I have never been sure how excellent a woman has to be in order to be qualified to stand on the world stage and represent her own country. I used to be afraid of failure for fear of seeing your disappointment. According to the rules of the Miss World pageant, each contestant has to first be the champion of the major beauty contest in her own country, and every country can send only one representative. Zhang Zilin,was surprised to find that after winning the Beijing selection contest, she was on her way to the final of the Miss China contest.
届世界小姐大赛中国总决赛冠军的是
27号
选手
张子宁，
恭喜！
With her healthy appearance and refreshing style, Zhang Zilin outplayed all the other beauties to become Miss China. 3 days later, she would represent China in the chase for the Miss World title.
我只有三天的时间来准备所有的事情，真的都来不及紧张，就已经到了全球总决赛的阵营里面。而且我当时觉得只要能顺顺利利来参加这个比赛，来享受这个过程，能够留一段很好的人生经历，就已经是非常不错的事情了。所以当你对自己没有一个什么要求的时候，自然也就不会感到紧张。
On November the 1st, 2007, Zhang Zilin arrived at Sanya City, Hainan Province. There, this Chinese girl, relatively unknown even in her own country, would face beauty contest winners from 105 countries and regions. Most of these beauties had received professional training, and some of them had been famous in their own countries as models or TV and film stars for quite some time.
包括从简单的言谈举止啊，走路的姿势啊，一直到英文啊，还有他的谈吐举止，如何的应对媒体，这些都是经过严格意义上的培训，所以他们每一个人看起来都非常非常的完美。但是对于我来说可能就缺少了一些这样的训练，但是很幸运我在之前有过一些模特的经历，所以对于走路啊，或者是平时的谈吐举止啊，可能还是也算是有一点点基础吧。
The Miss World final session lasts for a month, and contestants have to participate in 5 events: Beach Beauty, Miss Talent, Miss Sport, Top Model, and Beauty with a Purpose. As well as that, they have to go on a series of circuits and charity activities to collect contributions. In every single event, judges observe them the entire time, assessing their performance in terms of beauty and intelligence, following 18 indicators.
在最后几天真正进入决选阶段的时候，评委才会现身。但之前其实我根本就不知道有评委在。当时我来比赛第一天，我还不太会打扮，化妆技术还不算很高。但是我就看到网上有一些热心的网友给我提建议，说子琳希望你的化妆能够再加强一点，比如说可以化得再浓一点，或者是再更加的漂亮一点，更加的能够惹人注目一点。然后我想可能是需要改进的时候了，然后我就记得我当时每天晚上都会在卸妆之前为自己第二天的妆容再做一个练习，然后画上以后，然后看看哪里需要改进，然后再洗掉睡觉，第二天画。当时我记得是在海滩边上有一个很大的舞台，然后每一位佳丽都穿着沙滩装做一些展示啊，还有表演，这也是在我们所有的单项奖比赛中第一个进行的。当时我在根本没有想到过自己能进前十五名，前二十名都没有想过，没想到竟然得到了第三名的成绩，当时觉得特别特别的开心。可能我的真正在比赛中的自信心也是完全的从那时刻开始树立的。
Later, Zhang Zilin became the champion of the top model event.According to the rules of the competition, the champion of each individual event is promoted into the top 15 to take part in the final. For Zhang Zilin, getting that far would mean the opportunity to compete in the Miss World final on December the 1st.
At that time, we had 106 countries and regions of Zhang Zilin on the stage, having gone through some, for example, performance, and some singing, and some competition parts.最后选出了前十五名，十五名之后会选出前五，在最后的时刻是前五位佳丽站在台上。其实当时的一瞬间也会想过很多，包括我们去我们参加活动或者在一起讨论究竟谁会获得冠军。但是有一点我并不是很自信，因为虽然说我对自己的实力是有一点信心，因为在各个国家和网站的排行榜上面，就是民众投票里面，我是排在第一名的位置。但是很巧合，今年我是东道主选手，因为在我之前56届的世界小姐总决赛中，几乎没有，只有一位是东道主夺冠，所以这个几率是非常非常少的。我也是心里很忐忑。真的没有想到过这将是现实。没有想到过，可能只是像是梦中的一个场景，因为这是太神圣的一个荣誉。 现在看起来他们非常非常的漂亮，也非常非常的优秀。但是我和他们相比，可能少的就是一份压力，因为本来就只在三天之前才刚刚结束中国总决赛，觉得自己能够来参加世界总决赛，能够享受这一份美丽的感受，这一份美丽的旅程，就已经非常非常的开心了。所以在比赛的过程中，我也是非常轻松，然后没有任何的压力，不会是去模仿别人走路啊，或者是他们的一举一动，不会的。我只是在比赛过程中做了一个真实的自己。
Winning the Miss World title changed almost everything for Zhang Zilin overnight. In the international media, she was now being called the most beautiful woman in the world. She was China's top model, and her commercial value was now exceeding that of Ma Yanli and Qiu Ying in their best times. It was soon being said that many world-renowned fashion brands were planning to work with her. Although her tenure as Miss World would last for only 1 year,In that time, Zhang Zilin would be traveling to 57 countries, and in each one, she would be treated as a state guest.
但是我觉得金钱对于我来讲已经很不重要了。我觉得能够有这个头衔，然后能够有这份荣誉，已经是命运对我的赏赐了。我回答的可以吗？
非常好
啊，那就行。
非常好，就是为了更全面一些。
行，他会把我的话不是大段录，会剪切一些，
把最精彩的东西剪切。
行，那行。
比如说我们录一个小时。